Hey guys, it's Unknown here. We're back with another video. This time it's gonna be a tutorial, and that gap is kind of insane with the upload time. My uploads are hella inconsistent now, but I'll get started with the video. So basically, this tutorial will be covering how you can script a tilting effect for your Roblox characters, players. Character models, all that stuff. It shouldn't be that hard if you get to know how it works and stuff, so I'll just be showing you guys how it works. There's like other tutorials that covered it, but like they kinda have a copy this script type video, so it doesn't really explain it that well. So first thing you wanna do is head over to starter player, starter character scripts, starter player scripts, insert a local script, name this character built. Afterwards, you want to set some variables. So the first one we're going to do is run service. Or we can just do RS for short. We're gonna get the service. Next one we're gonna do is we're gonna set some player character variables. So player equals game dot players local player character player dot character or player dot character added weight. After that, we're gonna get insert a rig, for example. All right, so in a regular R6 type rig, you would have inside the torso, but actually no, the humanoid root part. There's a root joint here and there's some C frames here, so we got C0, C1, and these reference different parts of the torso. So we got the humanoid root part and the torso. These are pretty much welded together, I think. And say you edit the orientation of some of them, it will change how the character rotates. Okay, so let's get the root joint so we could edit it easier. First, alright, so with the root joint, alright, so we referenced the humanoid root part, the root joint, and then the original root joint C frame, so we could lean back to the original position when they stop moving. And now we're going to set the max tilt, so how far it will tilt. Say you want it to be maybe 8, 6, 5, and then we're gonna have the actual tilt, which is a C frame. All right, so after all this, we're gonna get to the run service part. So we're gonna have the till update every frame. I think that's what render step is. Yeah, prior to being the frame rendered. And we're gonna connect a function to it, pass a delta variable from the run from the render step. All right. So, in order to get the walk direction of which the player walks in, we have to get the move direction from the humanoid. So, it would be, and yeah, move direction here. So, depending on where they're moving, the move direction changes in the humanoid. So, the local move direction equals character dot humanoid dot move direction. But if we just use this move direction on the tilt, it wouldn't exactly tell which direction it's moving because we need to get the direction relative to where the character is moving. Pretty much in order to do that, we gotta use this function called okay, so we're gonna be using vector.object space for the as a C frame function thing, and pretty much what it does is that we get the tilt, just to simplify things, we get the tilt from the move direction from the No, in the humanoid root part. I don't know how to explain it well, but pretty much how we're gonna do it is a vector to object space. Inside here, we're gonna slide in the move direction. So our All right, so now they have the now that we have the move direction, we're gonna move things on over to the tilt. So the tilt will be set equal to, I think, all right, I think basically auto completed most of it. Roblox's scripting AI is crazy. Okay, so tilt, lerp. So we're gonna lerp it. This is pretty much tweening, but for C frames, I still think main servers could be better, but we're gonna be using lerp for now. Inside of lerp, we're gonna have a C frame angle. So C frame dot angles. All right. So inside here, we're gonna put math dot rads. Dot let's see, negative move direction dot, I think it was Z because we had to reverse it. So now that we have the tilt in radians, we need to multiply it outside of the radian. So we already have the tilt from the move direction. We have to multiply it to increase the tilt pretty much. So max tilt. There we go. Now we gotta do it for the other th what's it called? Axis. Yeah. All right. So we're just gonna copy and paste this. Voila. X. And then as for the Z angle, we don't have to worry about that. So we're just gonna put 0 inside of alpha. So this is, how do I ex describe this? Like the rate of change for the lerp slash tween. See, for me, I would go with 10 multiplied by delta time. So what delta time is it's like the frame time for each. It's the frame time pretty much. If we didn't add this, it would be kind of messed up because some players would have differing FPSs. We gotta increase it by the player's frame time and multiply by something so we could make it faster. I think that's a good explanation. So now that we have the tilt, we gotta actually tilt player model. Basically, we're gonna go with root joint dot c0, and then we're gonna set it equal to what was it called? Original root joint CF, so the original C frame for the root joint, and then we're gonna go with the tilt. I think that's it. Oh crap, guys, I just realized that it's R15 and not R6, so we're gonna quickly fix that. But I'll show you guys the method for R6 still. So we have to make some very slight modifications. Just gonna quickly add another variable here. Right, so this and then joint 0. I think that's it. Come on, please work, please work. No. Root joint? But, oh my god, it's not even root. Okay, guys, I've for real fixed it. So basically we gotta do the lower torso, we gotta get that. And the root, what's it called? The root motor 60 is in the lower torso, and then we have to modify that. Instead of the unit root part one, which is R6, it's not tilting enough. Hold on, we gotta add more max tilt. I think this is it. He still needs it. I think. Come on. Oh wait, it's like I don't think it's negative, is it? Mad. XD? Wait. Do I have to reverse it? No. Oh my god. Wait. Z X. Just playing around with angles at this point, man. Can see it's reversed. Hold on. How do I do this? X 0 max tilt 2. Maybe I not use a negative. Oh yeah, there we go. Wait, but I think it works. Okay. I think that's it. I don't know if it's like polished or not, 'cause it looks kind of weird, but for an R15 character, it's fine. As you can see, there's a bit of tilt backwards and forwards. Look at that. Okay, buckaroos, we got one more thing. So this is the R15 version. Shit. And then I'm just gonna R15. And then this is the R6 version. And inside of here, we got alright, so we're gonna change things up. So HRP.rootJoint. And then rootJoint up. I think for R6, it's negative. Same stuff, right? D, X. Move directions are flipped, which is kind of wild. Root joint. What? You're telling me. Is it just not loading fast enough, and I have to actually use wait for child? Come on. Come on, man. Wait, I have to actually switch to R6. My bad. As you can tell, this video is horribly unscripted. Such an epic unscripted video. Make sure you change your avatar type to R6. Okay. Please work. Please. Yes! As you can see, we got the tilt working. And pretty fire in my opinion. Like, that's lit. Big kudos to this dude in the dev form, because he gave me an idea of making this video. So go check out that dev form post. And then I'll leave some other resources that I also got in the dev form, because it's such an epic place. But yeah, any video suggestions that aren't core games are appreciated. But like, I guess I'll go for now, because it's getting hella late where I am. So have a good one, guys, and hopefully you guys enjoyed. So see ya.